Hey, what's going on everyone? Welcome back to the channel, where today is the first day pretty much where we're not going to be doing a routine from the Iron Wolf April Challenge. Because that is, well, done with, and now we're just going to get back to training. We continue, we don't stop. The April Challenge is over, but we continue with our own kind of training. So, today what I have for you is relatively simple in terms of following it, so you don't have to memorize too much. I feel like it's going to be a very interesting routine. So it consists of 25 4 pumps, 25 3 pumps, 25 2 pumps, and 25 1 pumps. And between these 25 pumps, you do 50 4 count flutter kicks. So you do the 25 4 pumps first, you do all of those, then you do 50 4 count flutter kicks, then you do 25 3 pumps, 50 4 count flutter kicks, etc. until you get to the last 50 4 count flutter kicks. So it's not all that difficult, it's quite simple to follow and remember. So yeah, there's not much else to say other than let's get to it. Gotta wear my wrist bands here. Now, you can also choose to possibly go with the 25 1 pumps first and work your way up to the 4 pumps. It's definitely a different kind of training because the way I'm going to do it, I'm going to start with a high volume of reps and get down to a lower volume of reps. If you feel like doing it the opposite way around, feel free to do so. No need to follow everything step by step. So, you know, whatever works for you. Alright, that said, let's get this going. 25 4 pumps. One. Two. Three. Four. Five. Six. Seven. Eight. Nine. Ten. One. Two. Three. Four. Five. Six. Seven. 7. Eight. Nine. One. Two. Five. It's 25 four pumps. Let's get down to the flutter kicks. 50 of those. One, two, five, ten. 15. 20. 25. 25 down, 25 to go. Let's get it. Five. 40. All right, we've got 10 to go. By the way, this is how I plan to break it up. 25, and then do 15, and then do 10. Five. 50. All right, feeling good. Okay, on to 25 three pumps. On my count, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, down. 1, 2. Three, four, five, six. Seven, eight, 9, 10. Sorry, my mouth is extremely dry. Need a sip. Four, five, six. Seven, eight, 9, 10. So 20. Moving on, 54 count flutter kicks. Let me check the time real quick. 14 minutes. Right. So, 54 counts. Go. Five, 10, 15. 20. Five down, 25 to go. 3, 2, 1. Time to go. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go. Tell you what, these flutter kicks, they hit hard. They are one of my favorite ab exercises because you really feel them. For me, more so than sit-ups, for instance. But that really depends from person to person. Alright, here we go. 25 two pumps are next. Let's get them done on my count. Five, 6. Two, 3, 4, 5, 6. Seven. One, 2. Okay, 50 flutter kicks are next. Five. Thought I heard something. Five, four, three, two, one, go. Alright. Once again, 25 down, 25 to go. Continuing. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go. And 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go. Alright, that's 50. Now we have 25 one pumps. Is it visible here? I think it is. Alright, here we go on my count. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Down. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 9, 10, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 9, 20, 1, 2, 3, 4, 25, 50 flutter kicks. I'll explain at the end why I decided to go a bit faster. Alright. Yeah, 50 flutter kicks. Okay. On my count. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go. Final time, 25 down, 25 to go. Continue in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go. Alright, 10 to go, continue in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. So that's the routine. Let's check the time. 29 minutes. That's pretty solid. So I know this isn't the heaviest of routines here. Let me kind of try this. So as I said, I know this isn't the heaviest of routines. It's not the, you know, the absolute most challenging routine ever, but it definitely is a good one. So it definitely gives you a pump, and it's quite interesting with the the flutter kicks. So the reason I chose flutter kicks for this routine was because for me personally, and as I mentioned throughout the workout, this might vary from person to person, but for me personally, flutter kicks do the most work for your core. So if for you, sit-ups do more work, then implement the sit-ups into this routine, because the goal is to have exhausted abs and to really have to focus on the burpees even more than you normally have to, because your core is exhausted, but you really need to keep that core tightened, because if you don't, then what's gonna happen is the following. I'll try and demonstrate here. So if you don't keep your core tightened, maybe this way you're gonna understand it better. What's gonna happen is during your burpees, say you do a one pump, normally you want it to look like this. So that would be a one pump, but if you don't keep your core tight, this is what's gonna likely happen. You know? So you're gonna have your back, which is either bending downwards, or you know, you're not going all the way, and you're just not gonna have the proper posture. So you just simply have to focus on keeping that core tight, even when your core is pretty much exhausted. So that's pretty much the goal of the routine. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I hope you guys give it a try. And let me know down below in the comment section what you thought of it. Now, one additional thing, if you're still watching, this is pretty random and not really relevant, but I just wanted to, you know, let you guys know that when I bought this shirt, okay, it's not like I fully fit in it, right? But it definitely wasn't this massive, okay? So for anyone doubting that these routines work, they do, 100%, trust me. So give it a try, let us know down below what you thought. If you did enjoy, make sure to smash the like button. And yeah, that being said, stay fit, stay healthy, stay strong. I'll see you in the next video. Peace out, everyone.